This is an important one. The story is we don't think are getting enough attention. In Johnson County, Indiana, an alarming number of childhood cancer diagnoses have parents wondering whether their environment is safe, and they're challenging the EPA to do better. It is happening in a place where more than half the county voted for Donald Trump and his promises to roll back such regulations. Now parents are asking the president, what would you do if it were your children? CNN's Miguel Marquez has the story.
I said, I love you, baby girl. And she said, I love you too, Mom.
Carrie Reinhart's 13-year-old daughter, Emma, developed a rare and aggressive brain cancer in 2014. Her last words?
She said, Mommy, something's not right. And I said, I know. I said, they're trying to fix it.
Emma died the next day, less than 4 months after her diagnosis, at the same hospital that same year. Stacy Davidson's 10-year-old stepson, Zane, was diagnosed with leukemia. 3 years later, he's in remission.
You start to see the lineup of the kids getting chemo, and you knew three of them at least from Johnson County every time you were in the hospital.
Dozens of children developing cancer in this once industrial suburb south of Indianapolis. Some parents increasingly convinced a toxic chemical is to blame. One concern here, Donald Trump, who easily won this county.
The regulation business has become a terrible business, and we're going to bring it down to where it should be.
His administration's environmental rollback may be complicating efforts to get answers and do what they feel necessary to protect their children.
Is that good?
Yep.
Last June, Aaron Tilley's family got the news.
Garrett is 12 years old and was diagnosed with B-cell ALL. There was just some warning signs that I noticed, so we took him to the pediatrician, and she did some blood work and then called us and let us know that it was leukemia.
The hunch, could all these cancers stem from a common source?
A mother's hunch.
Mom gut.
Driven by loss and love, Davidson and Reinhart created the group If It Was Your Child. They have since logged 58 pediatric cancer cases across Johnson County from 2008 to 2018. 24 of them in the town of Franklin alone. With the help of a local reporter, their mom gut led them to this nondescript old industrial site on the northern end of town where the carcinogen TCE, or trichloroethylene, had been dumped directly into city sewers for decades. The EPA studied the contaminated site in the 1980s, and a system to remove TCE was finally installed in the 90s. But decades later, revisiting the site in a city now more interested in economic development was, for some, unwelcome.
We've been called fear-mongers by agencies.
Overly emotional.
Paranoid moms.
Mm-hmm. The whole, like, if you're critical, then you don't like Franklin, or you're bashing Franklin, to me is the equivalent of saying, if I criticize Donald Trump, I'm anti-American. And to me, those two, that does not go hand in hand. In fact, I feel I'm more American.
They wanted more testing. When government agencies didn't step up, the environmental nonprofit Edison Wetlands Association did. It hired local environmental consultant John Mundell.
We found impacts in the air, ambient air, that matched some of the indoor air chemicals were found in the homes.
The results changed everything.
It went from, we knew it, to, are you kidding me? Are you actually kidding me?
They prompted the EPA to retest the site last year, revealing an underground plume of TCE under homes and neighborhoods and possibly expanding. The government put TCE on a list of cancer-causing chemicals in 2005, and Obama planned to restrict its use. The Trump administration has moved to delay that and many other environmental rules deemed too onerous on business and industry.
I think when you're relaxing environmental laws like is happening currently, the tendency is to not be aggressive in assessing sites. And so sites like this across the country would probably continue to be kind of put it on the back burner.
The cancers in Franklin have not been directly linked to TCE, but persistent mom gut drives Davidson and Reinhart to seek further testing and a remedy to make their town TCE free. In a statement, the EPA said, "We take the situation in the city of Franklin seriously and have worked expeditiously to investigate, develop a plan, implement the plan, and communicate our findings to the mayor and citizens of Franklin. EPA is committed to continuing this effort as long as it takes to ensure all contamination is addressed." Nationwide, there are hundreds, possibly thousands of sites similar to Franklin.
What is your message to the president?
He has children. You know, I mean, it just goes to our namesake of our organization. What would you do if it was your child? How hard would you fight?
Now, the Indiana Department of Health has officially tracked even more cases of pediatric cancer in Johnson County than these moms did through their group. Now, these moms also want the EPA to investigate why the toxic plume went unnoticed for so long, and they want this testing done this winter, as in right now. The EPA said it would do that, but all of that is on hold right now because of the government shutdown. Jim?
It's one more cost of the shutdown. Those investigations not getting done. Miguel Marquez, thanks very much. Yep.